We thank God for this opportunity that He gives us to just be His mouthpiece and bring His word unto you all.
और सम्मुख बनकर आप तक उसका वचन पहुंचाने के लिए इस संधि के लिए हम परमेश्वर का धन्यवाद देते हैं.
Truly, everything in our life is orchestrated and planned very, very well by the Lord.
और बहुत ही अच्छी तरीके से परमेश्वर ने हमारी जिंदगी की योजना बनाई है. हर चीज परमेश्वर ने बहुत अच्छी तरह से आखी हुई है.
I just want to thank all of you who are joined to this ministry, who are watching us and who are receiving from the word, who are sending us messages. We just want to thank God. We are really overwhelmed that you are, you know, it's all worth it. It's all worth it. All the effort that we put in here, when we receive messages that the word is really helping you, it's all worth it.
और जो आपके संदेश हमें मिल रहे हैं, जो भी इस वक्त हमें देख रहे हैं और इस मिनिस्ट्री को दिन प्रतिदिन देखते हैं और हमें सराह रहे हैं, ऐसा लगता है कि जो भी मेहनत हो रही है उसका हमें फल मिल रहा है और हमें बहुत खुशी महसूस हो रही
है. So today I just want to release a special anointing over all those who are watching us.
और इस वक्त रेवरेंड आप एक अभिषेक उठेंगे जो भी इस वक्त हमें देख रहा है.
Father, we just want to thank you, my God, for all those who are watching us, all those who are connected to us, my God. Father, we just want to thank you, my God. It's not about a particular church, it's not about our ministry, but it's all about your ministry and the body of Christ.
और परमेश्वर हम धन्यवाद देते हैं उन लोगों के लिए जो इस वक्त हमें देख रहे हैं, इस वक्त हमारे साथ जुड़े हुए हैं, क्योंकि ये सिर्फ एक कलीसिया के बारे में नहीं है, ये किसी सेवकाई के बारे में नहीं है, लेकिन ये तेरी सेवकाई के बारे में है.
Lord, let the word strengthen each one, my God, to pick up their assignment and go to the uttermost parts of the earth and establish Amen. Your kingdom.
और ये वचन उन्हें बल प्रदान करे ताकि वो अपना कार्यभार उठाकर वो कार्यभार दुनिया के कोने कोने तक पहुंचाए.
And much before that, Lord, every burden that is bowing them down, my God, right now let the word break it, my God, break the yoke of the enemy over them in Jesus' name.
और शत्रु का जो भी जुआ उन पर है, परमेश्वर तेरा वचन इस वक्त उसे तोड़े और जिस भी बोझ के तले वो दबे हुए हैं, आज वो बोझ सारे निकाल दिए जाएं.
Lord, as they listen to the word, let the word, my God, become their strength, my God. Let the word never keep them same in the same situation that they were last week, my God. I thank you for the word is changing them daily in Jesus' name.
परमेश्वर तेरा वचन उन्हें दिन ब दिन बदल रहा है और इस वचन से उन्हें ताकत प्रदान हो और जैसे वो पिछले हफ्ते थे वो इस वचन के द्वारा बदल दिए जाए और इस हफ्ते वो इस उसी तरह से ना रहे.
Amen. Okay, so today, like I said, we are continuing with the topic bringing down Jericho.
और जैसे हमने पिछले हफ्ते बताया था कि आज हम उसी विषय पर बात करने वाले हैं कि यरीहो की दीवार को कैसे गिराना है.
And those who have not watched the last sermon, please go and watch it because you'll understand much better when you finish off with the first part.
और ये वचन आपको तब समझ में आएगा जब आप पिछला वचन देखा होगा. अगर आपने नहीं देखा है तो पिछले हफ्ते का जो वचन है वो कृपया करके देखिए.
सो द बिगेस्ट जेरिको, वी हैव डिस्कस्ड अ लॉट ऑफ जेरिकोस, ब्रिंगिंग आउट अ लॉट ऑफ जेरिकोस इन द लास्ट सर्मन. टुडे लेट्स डिस्कस मोर. वन ऑफ द बिगेस्ट जेरिकोस इज आवर माइंड.
और पिछले हफ्ते हमने कुछ यरीहो की दीवारें देखी है और आज हम और ज्यादा देखेंगे, लेकिन सबसे बड़ी यरीहो की दीवार हमारा खुद का मन है.
इट इज अ माइंड दैट फेल्स टू अंडरस्टैंड द प्रोटोकॉल्स एंड द प्रिंसिपल्स एंड द कीज ऑफ द किंगडम.
और हमारा दिमाग, हमारा मस्तिष्क ये नहीं समझ पाता कि राज्य की क्या चाबियां है, राज्य के क्या नियम है, क्या सिद्धांत है.
वंस अगेन, one of the biggest Jerichos in our lives is a mind which does not understand the protocols, the principles and the keys of the kingdom of God.
और ये हमारा मन है, हमारा दिमाग है जो परमेश्वर के राज्य के चाबियां नहीं समझ पाता, सिद्धांत नहीं समझ पाता और उसके नियम नहीं समझ पाता।
Why, let me ask you, especially those who are here, why do you fear anything? Anything, could be just anything. Why do you fear, I want to ask you personally, why do you fear anything?
और जो यहाँ पर बैठे हुए हैं उनसे रेवरेंड पूछना चाहती है कि आप किसी चीज से क्यों डरते हैं?
See, they could, we are, listen, if you say that I don't fear anything, it's a lie. Yeah, we all fear. We do overcome it. By taking, grasping the word of God, working on ourselves, we do overcome it. But you can't say that, yeah, I have fear of nothing. So whatever fear you have, I don't want to know what you fear, but I just want to know the reason why you fear.
और वो जानना नहीं चाहती कि आप किस बात से डरते हो, लेकिन जानना चाहते हैं कि क्यों डरते हो, क्योंकि हम सभी लोग किसी ना किसी बात से कभी ना कभी भय खाते हैं। हाँ, हम उस पर विजय प्राप्त करते हैं, लेकिन ऐसा कोई बोल नहीं सकता कि मैं कभी किसी चीज से डरा नहीं।
So why do you fear? Can you give me a reason of fear?
It can have an adverse effect on our lives.
Okay.
Conditions.
All right.
Sometimes.
So you, the fear according to you is that it could adversely affect lives.
Consequences.
Like failure.
Consequences, failures, fear.
We are uncertain that we may be able to tackle that issue.
Uncertainty, yes.
It's a thought in the mind. That comes, fear is a thought in the mind that comes that makes us think, what is the next, what will happen if?
Right, what will happen if? If, right.
Your past experiences sometimes lead you to trauma, and because of that, you're afraid to venture and
Because
you have past experiences.
Right. The trauma of the past experiences, you have to translate.
और कभी कभी हमारी जिंदगी में कुछ चीजें पीछे घट जाती है, हमारा इतिहास ऐसा होता है जिसकी वजह से हम पर इतना बुरा असर पड़ता है कि हम आगे जाने से डरते हैं, या तो फिर कोई नई चीज करने से डरते हैं ये सोचकर कि क्या होगा अगर ये हुआ तो, या तो फिर हार मानने से या असफल होने से डरते हैं, या तो फिर इस बात से डरते हैं कि कहीं मैंने ये चीज कर दी तो इसका कहीं बुरा असर आगे जाकर ना हो।
यू नो, वी डिडंट हैव अ मीटिंग with our team and with our church members, a Zoom meeting where we were discussing face to face, where we were discussing these issues which are very real to our life.
और हमने एक Zoom meeting की थी पिछले दिनों में, जहाँ पर हमने हमारे कलीसिया के लोगों के साथ बात की और ऐसी उनके जीवन का अनुभव था और ऐसी जिंदगी थी और ऐसी बातें करी जो बहुत सच थी उनके जिंदगी में, बहुत असली थी।
You know, when these discussions are very needed. As a pastor, if you're watching me, I'm sure most of you all would be doing this, but having discussions with, see, it's not just for the church. Whether it be your business, whether it be your job, whether it be even your family, you know, sitting and having discussions, talking to each other, having real discussions is very, very important.
और ऐसी बातचीत करना बहुत जरूरी है, सिर्फ जिंदगी के बारे में नहीं, आपके व्यवसाय के बारे में, आपके रिश्ते नातों के बारे में। आप बैठकर एक दूसरे के साथ बातचीत करिए, आपके परिवार के साथ बातचीत करिए, क्योंकि ये बहुत जरूरी है।
इन योर बिजनेस यू गॉट टू सिट एंड टॉक टू योर टीम, यू नीड टू डिस्कस अ लॉट ऑफ इश्यूज व्हिच आर वेरी रियल, बिकॉज सी व्हाट हैपेंड वाज मोसेस फॉर अ वेरी लॉन्ग टाइम वाज ट्राइंग टू डील थिंग्स बाय हिमसेल्फ, या डेफिनेटली गॉड वाज विद हिम। But God always keeps people around you. That's one of the ministry of man. He keeps people, the right people around you, who you can go and speak and discuss. Because when you speak, a lot of Jerichos by itself just fall off. While you're discussing, you feel that, oh my God, I didn't even know that this was an issue with me. So discussion is very, very important.
और बातचीत में आपको ये समझ में आता है कि मुझे पता ही नहीं था मेरे साथ ये समस्या थी, और मूसा भी परमेश्वर का चुना हुआ था, लेकिन वो भी लोगों से बातचीत करता था। और अब बातचीत करना बहुत जरूरी है, क्योंकि उससे ही, बातचीत से ही कई सारी यरियों की दीवारें गिर जाती हैं।
यू नो, व्हेन मोसेस वेंट एंड स्पोक टू जेथ्रो, जेथ्रो गेव हिम अ सॉल्यूशन, ही हेल्प्ड हिम आउट, राइट? दैट्स हाउ, yeah, definitely Moses always had God, but Moses also needed people.
और हाँ, मूसा के पास परमेश्वर था, लेकिन मूसा को मनुष्य की भी जरूरत थी, इसलिए जब समस्या आई, वो अपने ससुर जेथ्रो के पास गया और उससे बातचीत की, जिससे उसे उस समस्या का हल मिला।
Right, so let me tell you, coming back to the topic, okay? the fear, I'll tell you, the foundation of all kind of fear. Right now, all of y'all spoke in different ways as to what do you think fear is. Why do you think that fear is in you? But let me tell you the foundation of all kind of fear.
और अभी बहुत सारे लोगों ने अपने अपने कारण दिए कि इस वजह से भय आता है, लेकिन उसकी नींव क्या है?
Fear mainly is being scared of losing something, right? That's what fear is.
Yes.
और भय क्या होता है? भय ये होता है कि मैं कहीं इस चीज को खो ना दूं.
It's a fear of losing something. That's always, you know, see, that is what is fear. Fear, you're very scared of losing something.
बहुत डर लगता है किसी चीज को खो देना.
बट यू फियर ऑफ लूजिंग समथिंग व्हेन यू नो यू कैन नॉट क्रिएट इट अगेन.
और तब ज्यादा डर लगता है, या डर इस बात से लगता है जब आप खो देने से डरते हो और ऐसी चीज जो आपको पता है कि मुझे वापस मैं इसे बना नहीं सकता या पा नहीं सकता.
लिसन टू मी, राइट डाउन समवेयर. फियर ऑफ लूजिंग समथिंग, यू फियर लूजिंग समथिंग, It's that thing which you cannot create again.
और उस बात से भय खाने से डरते हो कि मैं चीज खो दूंगा और मैं इसका वापस निर्माण नहीं कर सकता या वापस पा नहीं सकता.
Okay. Are you scared? Do you fear of spilling a glass of water? Do you really fear?
क्या आप पानी का ग्लास उंडेलने से डरते हो? नहीं.
Because you know you can go and refill it. You can go and replenish it.
क्योंकि आपको पता है आप उसे वापस भर दोगे.
Why? What if, listen, now the same example, literally the same example, if I ask you to do so in a desert where there is lack of water, when you just have one bottle of water, how would your reaction be to the same thing, the same situation?
और यही अगर पानी मैं आपको किसी रेती में दूं, किसी वीरान जगह पर दूं जहां पर बिल्कुल पानी नहीं है, तो तब क्या आपकी हालत होगी?
You know what? At that time, even spilling one drop is going to be costly. You're going to fear even spilling that one drop of water.
तब तो आप एक बूंद गिराने से भी डरोगे.
That's the way it is. Right? Now, we are in a place which is not a desert. We are in a kingdom that's not a desert. We are in a kingdom that has no lack. We are in a kingdom that has already promised us multiply. That has already promised us that I will give you resources. That has already told us that you can replenish. There is power to create in the kingdom to which we belong.
और हम जिस राज्य में है वो अरण्य नहीं है, उसमें किसी चीज की कमी नहीं है, बल्कि हमें ये दिया गया है कि हम पुनर् कर सके, हम फिर से चीजें भर सके, हम फिर से सारी चीजों को पुनर्निर्माण कर सकते हैं. इस तरह की ताकत हमें दी गई है.
राइट. बट यू नो व्हाट, दैट्स द माइंड. आई जस्ट टोल्ड यू, अ माइंड दैट डज नॉट अंडरस्टैंड द किंगडम इज द बिगेस्ट जेरिको इन योर लाइफ. सो इट्स द माइंड. So what have you to do? As long as your mind believes what this world is trying to teach you, as long as your mind believes what Satan is trying to put in you, you are always going to be in fear. Because in this world, listen to me, in this world, there is no promise of creating. There is no promise because the creator doesn't live in this world.
Mm-hmm.
There is no creator. Who is the God of this world?
Satan,
the prince of this world, right? He has no power of creation. He has no power of creation. He only knows how to destroy. Who has the power of creation? God alone. Right? Whose kingdom do you belong?
God's.
So when you belong to a kingdom where the king can create, and he says, greater things than what I have, you shall do.
Amen.
Greater things than what I have done, you shall do.
Amen.
That means God is saying, you are like me. I have made you in my likeness right in the beginning. If I have the power to create, you got it too. You also have the power to create. But the Jericho, that's my mind, which does not understand this principle of the kingdom, makes me sit down in the desert and I am trying to save up that one bottle and always fearing on saving that one bottle of water. Whereas I don't need to do so. I don't need to do this. I am in a kingdom where there is power to create. Power to create.
और हम ऐसे राज्यों में हैं जहाँ पर हमारे पास शक्ति है कि हम चीजें निर्माण कर सकते हैं. और इस दुनिया का राजकुमार कौन है? वो शैतान है. वो चीजें निर्माण नहीं कर सकता, उसे सिर्फ नाश करना ही आता है. लेकिन हमें अगर हम दुनिया की बातें सुने, हम अगर हम दुनिया के लोगों का सुनेंगे तो हमारे दिमाग में वो भय बैठ जाएगा कि अगर हमने ये चीज खो दी तो हम इसे पा नहीं सकते. और यहीं पर आता है कि हम उस अरण्य में उस पानी की जो बोतल है उसे गिराने से डरते रहेंगे.
ऑलराइट. Fear, every listen to me, every person on this earth, okay, rich, poor, average, whatever, that one thing every person, even if you ask a multi-millionaire, the one thing, the one fear, the biggest fear that he has is losing wealth. What do you have? All of us fear, oh my God, losing money, losing wealth. But we want to make more money and not lose that money. Fear of finances.
और वित्त का डर भी एक बहुत बड़ा डर है. कोई भी हो, गरीब हो, अमीर हो, औसत हो, एक सबसे बड़ा भय उनका ये होता है कि मैं अपना धन ना खो दूं.
Alright, listen now. That's why Jesus, that's why the word of God in the beginning and very plainly, very clearly says, I have given you the power to
create wealth.
No, I have given you the power to create wealth. Create wealth. The word of God says, I have given you power to create wealth. You're not getting me. I have given you the ingredients are with you. The recipe is with you. Then why do you fear? God always knew that the biggest fear of mankind would be to lose wealth, to lose all the money that they possess. That's why God says that don't be a fool. Change your mind. Understand the kingdom. The kingdom says when it comes to money, when it comes to finances, when it comes to wealth, I have given you the power to create. That means, where is money? Where is money? Please put your hand on you and say, it's in here. It's in here. It's in here. Where is health? In here. In here. You know why he said that I give you the power to create? Because he knew that the creator is going to be given to you. Where is the Holy Spirit? Come on now. What's his address? Inside you. So when the Holy Spirit, the Spirit of God is inside you, it can create a new body for you. It can create wealth for you. It can create opportunities for you. It can create relationships for you. Everything is inside here.
Amen.
But my mind that does not understand the kingdom is the biggest Jericho.
और हमारा मन तो सबसे बड़ा यरीहो है क्योंकि वो ये समझ नहीं पाता कि हमारे अंदर पवित्र आत्मा है और पवित्र आत्मा परमेश्वर निर्माण करने वाला परमेश्वर है और हम वो परमेश्वर के राज्य के लोग हैं. तो हमारे अंदर भी वो शक्ति है निर्माण करने की. हम पैसे निर्माण कर सकते हैं, हम हमारी सेहत निर्माण कर सकते हैं, हम संधियां उपलब्धियां निर्माण कर सकते हैं, हम रिश्ते निर्माण कर सकते हैं. सारी निर्माण करने की शक्ति हमें दी गई है. इसलिए पवित्र शास्त्र में भी पहले ही परमेश्वर ने लिखा है कि मैं तुम्हें धन बनाने की निर्मिति का सामर्थ्य देता हूँ. क्योंकि परमेश्वर जानता है कि सबसे बड़ी परेशानी इस दुनिया के लोगों को ये होगी कि वो धन खोने से डरेंगे.
Let's not go too far. For example, God has been telling you, work on your speech, work on your tempo, be soft spoken, be kind hearted, learn to love. For 1 month, God has been speaking to you this because God knows what's the issue with you. God knows what's your Jericho. Okay, now somebody comes to you, you don't know that that person is carrying your next blessing. You don't know, but that person comes to you untimely. That person comes to you when you're in a very, very bad mood. And what do? You speak the wrong words. You speak the rash words. And what happens? That person turns and goes away. God says, didn't I tell you? The power to create relationships and to walk into your miracle is in you. Now, who destroyed it? Then you blame God. God, why haven't I been blessed? Why haven't I multiplied? God says, every time I gave you a chance, you were the one who destroyed it. It's not coming from outside, it's coming from within you. That's why I'm preparing you day and night. What is the word of God? The word of God is not for anything else, it's to fix you. Because every damn miracle comes from you. It's from you. It's not going to come from outside, inside. It is birthed from you. That's why whenever Elijah prayed, he put his head between his knees and he prayed in that position because he knew every time he's praying, he's birthing. That's the importance of prayer. We don't do prayer just for fancy reasons. Oh my God, just to look holy. I don't pray. I pray because when I get to pray, I know I'm birthing. I got to be serious about things. I know that I'm birthing my character, my nature, changing myself. Beloveds, I'm telling you, this is deep. But if we don't understand this, we cannot go anywhere.
और परमेश्वर आपसे एक महीने से ये बात कर रहा है कि अपनी भाषा पर ध्यान दो, कैसे बात करते हो उस पर ध्यान दो, और फिर आप उसे नजरअंदाज करते हो, और फिर कोई आपकी जिंदगी में आता है जिसके पास आपका चमत्कार है, जिसके पास आपके लिए संधि है, और ऐसे वक्त पर आता है जहां पर आप अच्छे मनस्थिति में नहीं हो, और जब वो आता है तो आप उसे गलत बात कर देते हो या बुरी तरह से बात करते हो और वो मुड़कर चला जाता है, और परमेश्वर यही कहता है कि क्या मैंने तुमसे ये नहीं कहा था। तो यही यरीहो हमारे दिमाग में बैठा हुआ है, हम इन चीजों को समझ नहीं पाते। निर्माण करने की शक्ति हमारे अंदर दी गई है, लेकिन हम उस चीज को नजरअंदाज करते कि सब कुछ निर्माण करने का हमारे अंदर ही दिया गया है।
Alright, 2 Kings 4, let's not go there. In 2 Kings 4, the oil was always there. The oil was always there. God's reservoirs don't go dry.
और दो राजाओं 4 में हम पढ़ते हैं कि तेल हमेशा था, और परमेश्वर की जो मालमत्ता है, परमेश्वर की जो चीजें हैं, कभी खाली नहीं होती, कभी खत्म नहीं होती।
What was over there?
Vessels.
The vessels. The vessels were over. God says, I haven't stopped blessing you. You have stopped giving me vessels. You gave me vessels till last December. After December, you stopped. Now, where do you? How can I pour? How can I give the anointing? How can I send you favor? Where is the vessel? Whoever has given a vessel has been blessed.
Yes.
That's a testimony, at least my testimony. Whenever I have given God a vessel, He has filled it up till it's overflowing. So don't tell me that God doesn't bless or there is a lot of delay. It's just that your mind needs to understand the kingdom.
और उसमें क्या खत्म हो गया था? तेल खत्म नहीं हुआ था, लेकिन बर्तन खत्म हो गए थे। तो परमेश्वर यही कहता है कि मेरा जो आशीष है कभी खत्म नहीं होता, वो प्रोफ बहने वाला है। तुम्हारे जो बर्तन है वो खत्म हो गए हैं, तो आपने बर्तन पिछले दिसंबर तक ही दिए थे, उसके बाद आपने बर्तन कहाँ दिए? तो फिर परमेश्वर को कोसिए मत कि परमेश्वर देर करता है या परमेश्वर आशीष नहीं देता। ये रेवेंट की खुद की साक्ष्य है, गवाही है कि जब भी उन्होंने बर्तन दिए, परमेश्वर ने उसे पूरी तरह से भर दिया है।
Alright, the other, the next Jericho is ownership, want of ownership.
और दूसरा यरीहो की बात ये है कि हमें स्वामित्व चाहिए।
Listen, there are protocols in the kingdom that cannot be broken, that cannot be breached. If you breach these protocols, if you break these protocols, it's not possible that you will ask or command blessings from heaven.
और परमेश्वर के राज्य में कुछ संलेख है, और अगर आप ये संलेख नहीं, नियम तोड़ते हो, तो आपको परमेश्वर के राज्य की आशीष कभी मिल ही नहीं सकती।
It's strange when people don't prosper, the first thing that comes to their mind, let's change the church, let's change the pastor. It's real.
So true.
It's real. It's very real.
Yes.
We have been doing that because nobody explained to us that the problem is not with the pastor, it's not with the church, it's with me. I don't understand protocols. I don't understand kingdom systems. That's the problem.
और सबसे पहली चीज लोग ये करते हैं जब वो देखते हैं कि मेरे जिंदगी में कोई उन्नति नहीं करते तो कलीसिया बदल देता है, अपना पास्टर बदलते हैं, लेकिन ये समझते नहीं है कि समस्या मेरे साथ है, पास्टर अच्छे हैं, उनके साथ कोई समस्या नहीं है, ये मैं हूँ कि मुझे परमेश्वर के राज्य की प्रणाली और उसके सिद्धांत समझ में नहीं आते।
यू कैन गो टू 10 डिफरेंट चर्चेस बट योर प्रॉब्लम इज गोइंग टू बी द सेम।
आप भले ही 10 कलीसिया बदलो लेकिन आपकी समस्या नहीं बदलेगी।
You having the problem with you is that you have not recognized your problem. That's the problem.
Yes. और सबसे बड़ी समस्या तो यह है कि आप अपनी समस्या को ही नहीं पहचानते कि मेरी समस्या क्या है।
You know, when we say one-on-one with God, when we say alone time with God, what do you mean? When I'm doing my alone time with God, it's not for the world. It's first to fix me. Yes. It's first. You know what David said? David said, God, check me.
Yes.
Because if you don't check me now, there is no way I'm going into my next.
Yes.
So you've got to check me, Lord.
Yes.
That's what I'm saying. I don't care whether you're real with the people around you or no. That's none of my business. All that I'm trying to say, be real with God. Mm-hmm. Be real with your Father.
Mm-hmm.
When you go to Him, tell Him that, listen, you know what, God, this is my problem. I just can't get over it. Mm-hmm. I need your grace.
Mm-hmm.
And please, those prayers, God, I promise I will never do it again. Stop it. It's not in your, it's not in your control. You can't do it.
Yes.
So you know what? The best thing to pray is, God, give me the grace that I don't do it again.
Yes.
Give me the grace that I don't do it again.
Yes.
Because in me, if I had the power and the control, I would have never done it in the first place.
Right.
So what I'm trying to tell you is that the more real you are in that secret place, the more powerful you'll be outside.
और जितने आप सच्चे बने रहोगे आपके गुप्त स्थान में, उतना आप बाहर सामर्थ्यशाली बनोगे। और परमेश्वर के साथ सामने जाकर ये प्रार्थना मत कीजिए कि मैं अभी फिर से ये कभी नहीं करूंगा, क्योंकि आप में अगर खुद को रोकने की ताकत होती तब तक आप खुद को रोक चुके होते। लेकिन सही प्रार्थना ये है कि परमेश्वर मुझे तेरे अनुग्रह की जरूरत है ताकि ये मैं चीजें कभी ना दोहराऊं। तो जब आप परमेश्वर से अकेले में बात करते हैं तो दुनिया से ज्यादा अपने आप के लिए प्रार्थना कीजिए, अपने आप को परखिए और परमेश्वर को कहिए, जैसे दाऊद ने कहा था कि परमेश्वर मुझे टटोल, मुझे साफ कर क्योंकि पहले मैं ठीक हो जाऊं ताकि मैं किसी और को ठीक कर सकूं।
Listen, the prodigal son left his father's house too soon. He exited too soon.
और जो उड़ाव पुत्र था अपने पिता का घर उसने बहुत जल्दी छोड़ दिया।
Listen, wait, only those who wait shall see the glory of the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Let me tell you right now, you have not seen anything. You have not seen the best yet. If you want to see the best, don't exit. Don't exit the Father's house. Don't exit from the anointing. Don't exit. Yeah, right now you might be not seeing anything, but it's too soon to make a decision. Don't exit. Wait. Those who wait on the Lord, not those who pray. But those who wait on the Lord shall
renew
their strength and shall be put on wings of eagles.
Yes.
The eagle is the only bird that flies, that whose flight is way too high. It's the highest flight.
Yes.
If you want to go on that highest flight, if you want to see realms of the highest level of glory,
mm-hmm.
you gotta wait.
Yes.
You gotta wait.
Yes.
Don't exit. Wait. God doesn't need right now, God, at this situation, God doesn't need too much of your prayer, too much of your fasting. All that God needs is that you wait under the anointing. Wait in the Father's house. Don't exit.
रुकिए, पर उस अभिषेक को छोड़ के मत निकलिए, आपके पिता का घर छोड़ के मत निकलिए, पिता के साथ रहिए, क्योंकि जो भी परमेश्वर पर रुकता है, ये नहीं कि प्रार्थना करता है या तो फिर उपवास करता है, लेकिन जो परमेश्वर पर रुकता है वो नया बल प्राप्त करता है। और इसलिए रुकिए, भले ही आपको कुछ होता दिखाई नहीं देता, लेकिन बहुत जल्द निर्णय मत लीजिए, रुकिए।
Sometimes it's only waiting that is going to show you great heights.
और अगर आप रुकेंगे तभी आप वो नया स्तर देखेंगे, ऊंचा स्तर देखेंगे, उगाबों के तरह नया स्तर देखेंगे।
All right. So coming back, why did the prodigal son leave?
और वो उड़ाव पुत्र अपना पिता का घर छोड़के क्यों चला गया?
He wanted ownership. He wanted ownership.
Yes.
That means I need my share. God, where's my portion? Where's my portion? Where's my blessing? Where's my house? Where's my car? Where's my marriage? Where's my relationship? God, where's it? Mine, what belongs to me, what I should own. What I should own, where is my own? That mentality was the biggest Jericho. Because listen to me, the kingdom minds that you all are, you got to understand this, in this kingdom you don't own anything, you just have access. You only have access to blessings. You have access to power. You don't own anything. You don't own anything.
और उसके साथ समस्या ये थी कि उसे स्वामित्व चाहिए था, उसे मालकी चाहिए थी कि मेरी चीज कहाँ है, मेरा भाग कहाँ है, मुझे मेरा चाहिए। तो जब आपको मेरी शादी या मेरा घर या मेरी कार या मेरी चीजें, कि मेरी चीजें कहाँ है और मेरी आशीष कहाँ है, जब आप ऐसा करते हो, यही वो यरीहो की दीवार है आपके मन में जो गिरनी चाहिए। लेकिन परमेश्वर के राज्य में ये समझना जरूरी है कि आपको किसी भी चीज पर कोई हक नहीं, कोई स्वामित्व नहीं है, आपको सिर्फ वहां तक पहुंच है, आपको उस तक प्रवेश मिलता है, लेकिन आपको उस पर मालकी नहीं है।
सो व्हाई डू यू कम टू द हाउस ऑफ गॉड, व्हाई डू यू गिव योर टाइथ्स? यू गिव योर टाइथ्स टू टेल गॉड दैट गॉड व्हाटएवर यू हैव गिवन आई हैव एक्नॉलेज्ड इट कम्स फ्रॉम यू, इट डजंट बिलोंग टू मी, आई गिव यू your portion. God says give Caesar his.
Yes.
His portion. Why did God teach us write all this right in the beginning? So that we are always conscious that nothing belongs to me. So that we move in a, with a mindset that even if I get this, it doesn't belong to me. It's just given to me as long as I'm on this earth.
Yes.
I only have access to this. This pulpit is not my ownership. This church is not my ownership. These people are not my ownership. I am just a shepherd put on over them to overseer them.
Hallelujah.
That business that you have is not your own. It's been given to you. If you have this kind of a mindset, the kingdom mindset, I'm telling you, none shall be able to stop you from prospering and moving to great heights.
और जो भी आपको दिया गया है वो परमेश्वर से आया है, और जब आप दशमांश देते हैं आप ये परमेश्वर से कहते हैं कि मैं स्वीकार करता हूँ कि ये तुझसे है और ये तेरा तेरा भाग है। यीशु मसीह ने भी कहा कि कैसर को उसका भाग देना। तो ये सारी चीजें परमेश्वर क्यों सिखाता है, ये बताने के लिए कि जो भी हमारे पास है उस पर हमारी मालकी नहीं है, उस पर हमारा स्वामित्व नहीं है, ये सिर्फ हमें संभालने के लिए दी गई है। जो पुलपिट भी दिया गया है वो भी लोगों को संभालने के लिए, उन पर देखरेख करने के लिए दिया गया है, उस पर भी कोई मालकी नहीं है। या जो व्यवसाय दिया गया है वो भी परमेश्वर से है, उसके ऊपर आपकी कोई स्वामित्व नहीं है। तो जब ये आप चीजें समझोगे तब आपको सफलता पाने से कोई नहीं रोक सकता।
Watch this now. Today we are speaking something very very deep, right? Because I am putting before you two contradictions. But you got to understand it in the right way, beloved. Understand first of all, right now, what are we doing? We're trying to understand the what is the value of money according to the kingdom. This is the value of money according to the kingdom. That I don't own anything. I don't own anything. I only have access to it. All right. The next thing, if I give you the biggest note, okay, the biggest currency, and if somebody happens to tear it, you go to the shop and you ask the shopkeeper, you know what? It just happened accidentally. Now please give this. The shopkeeper will not accept it. He will not accept it. That small is the value of money in the kingdom. It becomes valueless. The biggest currency is a piece of paper which, if torn, is not going to give you any value. So you are stressing all your life for something that is so valueless. It's so valueless. You kill your brother, you steal from your family, you shut doors on your family for such a small thing which has no value. Today, if a rich man is in the hospital and the doctors have given up and says that in 2 hours this man is going to die, what power does those millions and millions in his bank account hold?
Nothing.
Absolutely nothing. That money at that time has no power. It is useless. Absolutely useless. So this is, beloved, what you need to understand, that money The real value, money is the least in the kingdom of God. That's what Creflo Dollar keeps saying. Money is the least in the kingdom of God. Alright, so now I change my mind from saying, oh my God, money, working for money, waking for money, walking for money, eating for money, sleeping for money. No. No longer. I will not chase you, but I will make you chase me.
Yes. Amen.
I will make you chase me.
Yes.
So the first thing, if you want money to chase you, you got to stop chasing money. You got to stop chasing money. You got to clear that greed inside of you. Clear it up. It's okay. That's why Paul says that I know how to live in abundance and I know how to go without anything.
Amen.
That's the power. That's the power Jesus has given you. That you know what? It's not just that money that making you live. No. Money is the least in the kingdom of God. Are you with me?
Yes.
Yes.
Okay. Creflo Dollar ये कहता रहता है कि पैसे की कीमत परमेश्वर के राज्य में सबसे कम है और अगर आपकी कोई सबसे बड़ी नोट है और वो थोड़ी सी फट जाती है और आप किसी दुकानदार के पास जाते हो कि मुझे इससे ये चीज खरीदे तो गलती से फट गई तो कोई भी उस नोट को स्वीकार नहीं करेगा तो इतनी कम कीमत है या कोई कीमत ही नहीं है उस कागज के टुकड़े पर. और कोई ऐसा इंसान जो बहुत धनवान है लेकिन उसे डॉक्टर ने कह दिया कि अब जिंदा नहीं रहेगा तो जो करोड़ों उसके बैंक में पड़े हैं उस चीज का क्या फायदा. तो पैसे का कोई जिंदगी में फायदा नहीं है. आपके पास पैसा तब आएगा जब आप उसके पीछे दौड़ना बंद करोगे तब पैसा आपके पीछे दौड़ने लगेगा.
एनीथिंग दैट यू मेक गॉड एंड दैट यू गिव गॉड्स प्लेस इन योर लाइफ इज गोना गिव यू ट्रबल. Is going to give you trouble. So that's why right now decide that God, you are God in my life. You are the I am and everything comes after you.
Amen.
Nothing takes your place. I'm not going to have sleepless nights only because my bank account shows so less. No, because I have the power to create that thing.
Hallelujah.
One thing that you can't create is God.
Yes.
That's who you should fear.
Yes.
Oh. Amen.
That's
yes.
who you should fear.
Yes.
Everything else I can create. Because the Creator is sitting on His throne in my life.
Amen.
Right?
Yeah.
और सिर्फ एक चीज से आपको डरना है वो है परमेश्वर से क्योंकि आप परमेश्वर का निर्माण नहीं कर सकते. तो आप रात को जागना बंद कर दीजिए कि मेरे बैंक में पैसे नहीं है क्योंकि परमेश्वर ने आपको उसे निर्माण करने की शक्ति दी हुई है.
The prodigal son had to come back very soon, saying, "In my father's house, everything came to me in a platter. There, I go to eat pig's food." I go to beg for food. Listen, beloveds, that's the difference between you in Christ, under the anointing,
yes.
fulfilling the protocols. Anything you do, you will receive success without struggle.
Amen.
You know why? Yes. I don't say that. Your Father has promised that over you. He has broken the curse of
right.
sweat Amen. And blood. You know what? Many people say, oh my God, for years together I have been trying, but that's not happened. I don't know how come suddenly... When I am talking to you, friends with you, or whatever, it's just happened. You know why? Because it's the anointing that's sitting on
Amen.
You.
Amen.
It's the anointing that's sitting on you that is causing that one friend of yours to prosper.
Yeah.
Because you have the King of Glory who you are submitted to. So through you, it's all working. Not only for yourself, but even for people who are with you, around you.
Yes.
Right? So that's what I'm trying to tell you. I'm trying to tell you that when you're under the anointing, you don't have to
stress.
You don't have to. Listen, hard work is there, definitely. Jesus mm-hmm. worked hard.
Yes.
There's a difference between hard work and being sincere, mm-hmm. and there's a difference in struggling.
Mm-hmm.
Struggling means standing outside closed doors, trying to do everything you can, but those doors still remain closed. Mm-hmm. But hard work means I'm doing my hard work, I'm getting my fruits, I'm stepping higher and higher, mm-hmm. moving forward gracefully.
Yes.
Why? Because I'm the king's house. I'm in my father's house. As long as I'm in my father's house, I don't need to worry.
Yes.
It's all things are working together for my good.
और उस बुढ़ाओ पुत्र ने ये समझा कि जब तक मैं मेरे पिता के घर में था मुझे सब कुछ थाल पर मिल रहा था लेकिन अब जब मैं पिता के घर से निकल गया हूँ मुझे सुअरों का खाना खाना पड़ रहा है. यही फर्क होता है जब आप अभिषेक के अंदर होते हो जब आप पिता के घर में होते हो और जब आप उससे बाहर निकलते हो. तो जब आप अभिषेक के अंदर होते हो वो अभिषेक है जो सिर्फ आपको ही भरभराटी नहीं दिलाता सफलता नहीं दिलाता लेकिन आपके आसपास के लोग जो आपके साथ जुड़े हुए हैं उन्हें तक सफलता दिलाता है. वो आपको आकर कहेंगे कि मैं इतने साल संघर्ष कर रहा था लेकिन नहीं हुआ लेकिन अब तुमसे बात कर ये हो रहा है. तो संघर्ष मेहनत करना जरूरी है. मेहनत करना और संघर्ष करने में फर्क होता है। मेहनत करना ये होता है कि आप काम कर रहे हो और आप उसके फल देख रहे हो, लेकिन संघर्ष करना ये होता है कि आप बंद दरवाजों के बाहर खड़े रहकर सब कुछ किए जा रहे हो लेकिन आपको कोई चीज हासिल नहीं हो रही।
You know, your inability to understand the kingdom protocols causes every prophecy to be a lie. Your inability to understand the protocols of the kingdom. Yeah, we are teaching you the protocols. But your inability to understand it, take it back home and apply it and work it in your life causes your prophecies to look like a lie. And then you say that, no, what you prophesied was a lie. No, the prophecy was never a lie. Was never a lie. The lie, it had to become a lie for you because you did not fulfill the needs and requirements of the prophecy.
और आप कहोगे कि मेरे ऊपर तो इतनी भविष्यवाणी की लेकिन सारी झूठी निकली। वो भविष्यवाणियां झूठ नहीं थी बल्कि आप जो परमेश्वर के राज्य के जो नियम है, जो संलेख है, उसे समझ नहीं पा रहे हो। आप वचन नहीं सुन रहे हो, जो वचन कहता है करने के लिए आप वो नहीं कर रहे हो और फिर आप कह रहे हो कि वो भविष्यवाणियां झूठ नहीं थी, वो भविष्य झूठ निकली। वो भविष्यवाणियां झूठ नहीं थी बल्कि जो उस भविष्यवाणी को पूरी करने के लिए चीजें चाहिए थी आपने वो नहीं करी।
लेट्स जस्ट टेक सॉल, ओके। First of all, Saul's mind could never understand the kingdom principles. On the other hand, David very well understood the father's business. Right? So Saul, when he should have waited for Samuel to raise the offering, okay? He should have waited for the priesthood, but yes. Samuel, but Saul did not understand the importance of priesthood in the kingdom.
Right.
So Saul said, it is getting too late, I'm getting desperate, the Philistines are chasing me and this is happening and that is happening, so I just did it. No, Saul, that was not, you know what Samuel said? He said, Saul, you have done a foolish thing. You have done a foolish thing. There is nothing too desperate for you to break protocols. Understand this.
Right.
No, this time, two less of money, I can't give my offerings. There is nothing too desperate for you to break protocols.
Yes.
No, I stay too far. I can't attend church. I can't. Every day coming and going, no, just doesn't happen. Too much of fuel, too much of money. Nothing should make you skip protocols.
Amen.
Yes.
No.
Right.
You can't do that. Do you know the consequence was that God said, Saul, your kingdom shall not reign. Your kingdom shall not reign. God immediately pulled Saul's kingdom down. Yes. He said, I will not give you that position. Why? Because you have broken protocols.
और शॉल के साथ क्या हुआ? शॉल परमेश्वर के राज्य के सिद्धांत नहीं समझ पाया, उसका संलेख नियम नहीं समझ पाया और वो इतना गड़बड़ी में और इतनी जल्दी में था कि उसने याजकपन को नहीं स्वीकारा और वो शमूएल के लिए रुका नहीं और उसने ही अर्पण कर दिए। लेकिन दूसरी जगह पर दाऊद परमेश्वर के जो नियम है, परमेश्वर के राज्य के नियम है, वो समझा और तभी शमूएल ने क्या कहा कि शॉल तूने एक बहुत मूर्खता की चीज की है, जिसका क्या परिणाम हुआ कि शॉल से उसका राज्य छीन लिया गया। और यही कोई भी चीज आपको इतनी जल्दबाजी में नहीं डाल देनी चाहिए, इतने हदबंद में नहीं डाल देनी चाहिए कि आप परमेश्वर के नियम ना मानो। और आप ये कहोगे कि अभी घर में अभी मेरे पास पैसे नहीं है या तो फिर पैसे की कमी है तो मैं इस बार दशमांश नहीं डालूंगा या तो फिर मैं दूर रहता हूं तो मैं कलीसिया नहीं जाऊंगा, कौन इतना दूर पेट्रोल खर्चा करके जाए। कोई भी चीज आपको परमेश्वर के राज्य के नियम तोड़ने नहीं लगानी चाहिए।
The other instance was that Saul lied to Samuel. He disobeyed instructions. For what? Again, ownership. Right? Saul disobeyed because he wanted to own that spoil. Whereas God was saying, I don't want you to touch that spoil. But because for the greed of ownership, he said, you know what, forget, how is Samuel going to know? He bypassed God. That's what I'm trying to say. I'm trying to divert your mind to sonship and to serving God and not to ownership. Because as long as you have that mentality of ownership, right, you will keep breaking laws and breaking protocols. And that's what the enemy wants you to do, so that you never move forward in life. Are you understanding? Saul broke, he disobeyed God for ownership because he wanted to own the spoil.
और शॉल ने क्या किया, शॉल ने आज्ञा नहीं पाली. क्यों आज्ञा नहीं पाली? और ऊपर से उसने शमूएल से झूठ कहा, क्योंकि उसे वो जो लूट थी उसे अपने लिए चाहिए थी, और उसने शमूएल से कहा कि ये मैंने परमेश्वर के लिए रखा है. लेकिन उस वक्त उसने उसे स्वामित्व चाहिए था, उसे उस चीज की मालकी चाहिए थी, इसलिए उसने परमेश्वर की आज्ञा तोड़ी, जबकि परमेश्वर ने उसे कहा था कि उस लूट को हाथ नहीं लगाना है. यही गलती हम लोग भी करते हैं जब हमें किसी चीज की स्वामित्व चाहिए होती है, उसकी मालकी चाहिए होती है.
You know, if there is no process behind your miracle, if you don't know how you've got a miracle, that was just by chance. That was just by chance.
और जब आपको पता नहीं कि आपका चमत्कार की प्रक्रिया क्या थी, आपने क्या प्रक्रिया की जिससे आपको ये चमत्कार मिला, तो फिर वो चमत्कार आपको सिर्फ नसीब से मिल गया.
But if you know, I did this, then I did this, then I did this. And then the miracle happened. If you understand the methods of how you came to this place, you can do it again and have the miracle again.
Amen.
Right?
True.
So listen, beloveds of God, don't live for chances and don't live for luck. This kingdom does not work like that. This kingdom is a kingdom that gives you the intelligence, that gives you the wisdom and says, now you've got the key, now go, every door you will have access to. Because you got the key. Those who do not understand, oh, okay, fine, I'm coming to church once in a while, not taking the word seriously, not even trying to do something in the word or applying the word, suddenly just a miracle happens. Oh my God, hallelujah, praise God, thank you, Jesus, worship you as much as I can. That's it. No, that's going to be only seasonal. That's going to be only seasonal. That's just called a breakthrough.
True.
For a season. But blessings are that which continues. You know, listen, write this down. You guys put status, right? Listen to me now. For a month, you'll write your whatever you call that under your status. For a month, keep that status. Whatever you put is your business, but put the word copious blessings under that. Copious blessings under that. You know why? What do I mean by copious blessings?
Unending.
That means I'm supposed to live in a place where my barns shall never dry.
Amen.
Where continuous blessings. I don't know from where they're coming, but I'm doing my process, and that's coming as a result of the process. As a result of, I know how to now bring it in my life. Listen to me, beloveds. Let's not live in ignorance. The body of Christ needs to know how to create. If we know how to create, we will never have to live without it.
Amen.
We will never have to beg, borrow, steal and cry. Because God has given us the power to create. And it's the process. What we're speaking right now, it's not a waste of time. I'm telling you, this time that you have given here to this world is the biggest investment in your life. And if you take this investment seriously, I'm telling you, you will really be on eagle's wings.
Amen.
और आपको प्रक्रिया समझनी है कि आपको कैसे वो चमत्कार मिला है, कि मैंने ये किया, फिर ये किया, फिर ये किया, और फिर मुझे ये चमत्कार या तो फिर ये आशीष मुझे मिली. क्योंकि आप उस आशीष को फिर से निर्माण करने की ताकत रखते हो, क्योंकि आपको पता है कि ये आशीष मुझे कैसे मिली. लेकिन जब आपको पता नहीं होता, तो फिर आपको सिर्फ एक नसीब के खेल से या तकदीर के खेल से आपको मिल जाता है, और फिर परमेश्वर से एक छुटकारा दे देता है. लेकिन ये जो आशीष है आपके सिर्फ थोड़े दिनों के लिए आपकी जिंदगी में टिकती है, क्योंकि फिर वो खत्म हो जाने के बाद आपको फिर पता नहीं चलता कि ये वापस कैसे हासिल करनी है. तो फिर ये प्रक्रिया हमें समझनी है. आप जो अभी हमें सुन रहे हैं वो निवेश कर रहे हैं अपना वक्त ये जानने के लिए कि ये आशीष हमें कैसे प्राप्त करनी है, उसका पुनर्निर्माण कैसे करना है.
Alright. So now we are getting into the next very important thing. I'm closing very soon, but I want you to get this very clearly. Alright. When you learn to put the right value over things, you will never be disappointed.
और जब तीसरी महत्वपूर्ण की बात यह है कि जब आप चीजों पे उसका सही मूल्य लगाओगे, आप कभी निराश नहीं होंगे.
Alright, we've spoken about finances, one part of it, right? Have you understood it?
Yes.
Yes. Yes.
Alright.
Yes.
Great. Now, okay. How many things have you lost because of lack of financial resources? How many relationships have gone bitter? How many delays have happened? How many things have you lost in the past because of lack of financial resources?
और जब आपके पास वित्त की कमी थी पिछले दिनों में, तब आपने कितनी सारी चीजें खो दी। आपके रिश्तों में कड़वाहट आ गई, आपको कुछ चीज करनी थी लेकिन उसमें देरी हो रही है, तो पैसे की कमी की वजह से कितनी सारी चीजें आपने खो दी हैं।
यू कांट पीसफुली सर्व गॉड, यू कांट पीसफुली सर्व गॉड इफ यू आर स्ट्रगलिंग फाइनेंशियली। दैट्स द रियलिटी।
आप परमेश्वर की शांति से सेवा नहीं कर सकते अगर आप पैसों के मामले में, वित्त के मामले में संघर्ष कर रहे हो।
All right. You know why I explained to you the first half? So that your intentions to get money was clear.
Yes.
All right. So that you don't become a slave to money, but you cause money to be your slave and to run after you.
Amen.
That's why I explained to you the first part.
Amen.
Now the second part. Why do I need money?
और हमने पहला भाग इसलिए देखा क्योंकि हमें हमें इरादे सही करने थे कि हमें पैसा क्यों चाहिए, ताकि हम पैसे के गुलाम ना बने बल्कि पैसा हमारा गुलाम बने। और दूसरा भाग ये है कि हमें पैसे क्यों चाहिए।
Why do you need money? One thing that you need money is not for ownership, because that's settled now. In my mind that's settled.
Yes.
No ownership. I am not going to say it's me, but no. I need money so that I can have more time, I can have more resources, I can be more effective.
और मुझे पैसे इसलिए चाहिए, ताकि ये इसलिए नहीं कि मुझे स्वामित्व चाहिए और मैं अपनी चीजें खरीद सकूं, नहीं। पहली बात तो मुझे प्रभावी होना है और मुझे मेरे पास चीजें प्रावधान होने चाहिए और मेरे पास ज्यादा समय बचना चाहिए।
Do you know the biggest, the most wonderful and the most powerful and effective preachers have, they travel only in their own charters.
Yes.
Why? They only travel, forget about land. They don't even talk about it. They fly in their own charters. Is it wrong?
No.
Should they be guilty?
No.
The most powerful preachers are great businessmen who own certain things which even the richest don't own in this land. Should they be guilty?
No.
Why have they done that? They have done that because if they need to go from Pune to say Bangalore, they have enough money to buy a flight ticket. What happens? They save time. If you're going to start on a cycle, how many days or months is it going to take you? If you're going to drive, how many days is it going to take you? Don't you think that that's a waste of time? And don't you think that we have shortage of time?
Yes.
Jesus is coming anytime.
Yeah.
So Jesus says, I'm ready to give you a charter, dude. I am ready to do that for you. Yes, I'm ready to do that for you. But why don't you shift your mind and break that Jericho and try to understand the economics as I want to explain to you? Why don't you try to understand the kingdom economics?
Mm-hmm.
So the day that greed for money in you has gone, my goodness, I'm telling you, money will follow you. It will come seeking you. You know why? Because now my intentions are not wrong intentions. I don't want to go and spend money and womanize or what do you say? I don't want to drink and party. No, that's not what I need the money for. I need the money to be effective. I need the money so that I can go next month to Turkey and establish the kingdom
Amen.
Of God.
Yes.
And after that, the
yes.
next month, I can go to Spain, live there for 20 days and do the kingdom work there.
Amen.
I need the money for all that. So you don't have to feel guilty. You don't have to feel guilty when you buy fancy cars. You don't have to feel guilty when you do the good things, as long as your intentions are right.
Yes.
Amen.
It's all between you and God. Let me tell you one thing. Before you become too rich, understand this. People are always going to speak bad about you. You've not become rich the world way. You've become rich the kingdom way.
Amen.
और जब हम बड़े बड़े प्रचारक को देखते हैं, उनके पास पैसे होते हैं हवाई जहाज का टिकट खरीदने के लिए, लेकिन फिर भी उनके पास खुद का हवाई जहाज है, क्योंकि अगर उन्हें पुणे से बैंगलोर जाना है तो वो बिना टिकट लिए जाते हैं, क्योंकि उनके समय उतना बचता है और वो उतने प्रभावी होते हैं। तो क्या उन्हें इसके बारे में बुरा लगना चाहिए? नहीं। तो जब आपके इरादे सही होते हैं, जब आप परमेश्वर के राज्य के लिए होते हो, क्योंकि जब आप ये जान जाते हो कि पैसे के ऊपर मेरा कोई स्वामित्व नहीं है, जब ये जो पैसे की लालसा है आपसे निकल जाती है, तब पैसा आपको ढूंढते हुए आएगा। तो अगर मेरे पास पैसा है तो मैं अगले महीने टर्की जाकर परमेश्वर का काम कर सकता हूँ, या तो फिर 20 दिन स्पेन में रहकर परमेश्वर का काम कर सकता हूँ। इन चीज सब चीजों के लिए पैसे की जरूरत है। तो परमेश्वर चाहता है कि जैसे पैसे का अभ्यास है तो मुझसे सीखो, परमेश्वर के राज्य के हिसाब से सीखो। और जब आप धनवान बन जाओगे, जब आप परमेश्वर के राज्य के नियम के अनुसार धनवान बन जाओगे, तब लोग आपकी बुराई जरूर करने लगेंगे।
Listen, you need money to pay off your bills and live at peace, so that when you are peaceful, when there's nobody coming and knocking your doors, you are at peace with God. Mm-hmm. When you know that I have 10 branches, at every branch I got wonderful helpers who are doing their work faithfully and getting me the money, will there be a need for you to waste time outside?
No.
Then for hours you can be Moses.
Yes. Yes.
Right?
Yes.
I'm showing you how to plan your life. People plan for retirement. Why? Because once they retire, then they can enjoy life. Yeah, we also need that. But I don't need my retirement at the age of 60. I need to enjoy things right now. I need to enjoy things in another 2 years. I need to have my finances overflowing. And settle. Amen. Enough of helpers so that I can be Moses.
Amen.
Because do you know what the world needs? Is Moses.
Yes.
Do you know what the world needs? Is a revelation that comes from Moses. Do you know what the world needs? Is your relationship with God. Because you don't even understand that your relationship with God is benefiting nations. Your relationship with God has established families who are going to die. Your relationship with God has healed that man who couldn't walk, but now because of the faith that you have instilled in that man, he is getting better and better each day. That's what is the power of your relationship with God. So God is saying, let your mind work in this way, that God, I need so much money overflowing so that I have the freedom to be Moses. So that I can be somebody's Moses each day. So that not Sunday to Sunday I come and I preach and I become somebody's Moses. No, God, that each day, you want me to travel to different nations each day, I should be able to do that.
Amen.
Amen.
And for that, God says, too sad. But I am not going to send it out from heaven. You got to use all the keys and multiply. I'm ready to multiply for you. Because see, in Psalms 25, what does it say? Psalms 35 and verse 27, God says, I take pleasure in your prosperity. Because I know, my child, when you prosper, you are only going to establish my kingdom. That's the way your mind works now.
ऐसा होता है जब आपको उसकी चिंता नहीं होती है, तब आप किसी के मूसा बन सकते हो। जब आपको पता है कि जगह जगह पर मेरी शाखाएं हैं और वहां पर विश्वासु लोग हैं जो मेरे लिए काम कर रहे हैं और कंपनी के लिए पैसा कमा रहे हैं, तब आप शांति से किसी के मूसा हो सकते हो। सिर्फ इतवार के दिन नहीं, बल्कि रोज किसी के लिए मूसा हो सकते हो। आप परमेश्वर के लिए समय दे सकते हो, आप किसी का घर बसा सकते हो, या तो फिर आप किसी को आत्महत्या करने से रोक सकते हो, या तो फिर किसी की जिंदगी में खुशहाली ला सकते हो। लेकिन ये तब होगा जब आप उस चीज के लिए शांति से समय दे सकते हो। तो परमेश्वर जानता है कि तुम्हें परमेश्वर का राज्य स्थापन करने के लिए पैसे की जरूरत है, लेकिन बात यह है कि वो ऊपर से नहीं आने वाला है। परमेश्वर ने आपको उसका निर्माण करने की ताकत दे रखी है।
ओके, नाउ आई एम क्लोजिंग वेरी सून, बट आई डोंट वांट टू लीव दीज लिटिल बिट्स फॉर द नेक्स्ट टाइम। ओके, नाउ इट्स वेरी वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट, इफ यू वॉन्ट टू सक्सीड, मल्टीप्लाई एंड replenish, इट्स वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट दैट यू पुट द राइट वैल्यू इवन ऑन योर सेल्फ.
और अगर आपको पुनर्पूर्ति करनी है, आपको गुणन करना है और आपको चीजें बढ़ानी है, तो एक चीज बहुत महत्व की है कि आपको खुद पर भी सही मूल्य लगाना है.
आई गॉट टू वर्क ऑन माई सेल्फ, आई गॉट टू ब्रिंग वैल्यू टू माई सेल्फ. एस्थर हदासा जस्ट डिडंट कम एंड एंटर द किंग्स पैलेस एंड बी लाइक यू नो व्हाट किंग जस्ट लाइक मी द वे आई एम. द किंग वुड बी द व्हाई शुड आई, व्हाई शुड आई लाइक यू द वे यू आर, यू डोंट फिट द प्लेस ऑफ अ क्वीन. नो आई एम जस्ट द वे आई एम, आई डोंट नीड टू do all these kind of things, it's all worldly things. Stop acting foolish. Esther took 1 year to polish, to scrub, and to be fit for the garment.
Yes.
Of the queen.
Yes.
Many of us, listen, there's a garment that's already customized
right
for you. But now you have to alter yourself, either shrink or become huge, to fit in that garment which God has already customized for you. But the problem is, no, I'm not going to do that. Why should I do that? Why? That's not your humility or your holiness speaking. It's your pride.
Yes.
It's your pride. Don't act like the Pharisees. They were full of pride. No, we can't turn, we can't change. A person who does not have a teachable spirit will never go further in this kingdom. You need to have a teachable spirit. It's okay, fine. You think that's not right? You think the way I talk to my customer is not right? Okay, fine, let me change. You think the way I dress up is not right? Okay, let me change. You think I'm too shabby while I'm going for work? Let me change. Because that's the way to grow. That's the way to grow. So what happens, beloveds, is when you start putting value on yourself, that's the time the king is going to come and recognize you and be like, you know what, seriously, you're Hadassah? From that small town, doesn't look like it. I chose you because you look of my stature. I chose you because you look like a born queen. You look like a born queen. Who do you belong to? Do you belong to your father who was living in the village? Do you belong to your grandparents who were living in the village? Who do you belong to? The King of Kings, the Lord of Lords, the Alpha and the Omega. So how should I look? How should I exhibit myself to the world? That's what plays a very important role. Because if you don't value yourself, you can forever confess Isaiah, kings are coming to do business with me. Kings will just come and be, oops, I think that's the wrong one. No.
Yeah.
Sometimes, listen to me, I have come across testimonies where people have been exalted, promoted, even without having the skills. Exactly. It's just because the way they managed it looks so beautiful. It's just the way that they managed everything looks so, so impeccable that they were like, listen, skills, we'll teach you. We'll teach you the skills. But you know what? What we need is that inborn manager that's in you. We know that you can manage and you can represent our company in the world. That's why we choose you. So forget about the skills, we'll teach you the skills.
और हदसा एक दिन में एस्तर नहीं बनी. हदसा ने ये नहीं कहा कि मैं जैसी हूँ वैसे ही मुझे राजा ने स्वीकारना चाहिए, बल्कि उसने एक साल लगा दिया अपने आप को तैयार करने में. और तब जब वो राजा के सामने गई तब राजा उसे पहचान भी नहीं पाया. तो इसी तरह से हमें अपने आप पर मूल्य लगाना है. ये मूर्खता करके नहीं कहनी है कि मैं जैसे हूँ वैसे आपने स्वीकार करना चाहिए और मैं अपने आप को नहीं बदलूंगा. तो ये आपकी पवित्रता नहीं है, ये आपकी नम्रता नहीं है, बल्कि ये आपका घमंड है कि आप बदलना नहीं चाहते. हमेशा सिखाने वाला आत्मा रखना चाहिए. क्योंकि अगर आपको ऐसा लगता है कि मैं जिस तरह से अपने कस्टमर के साथ या अपने ग्राहकों के साथ बात करता हूँ सही नहीं है, तो अपने आप को बदलना चाहिए. इस तरह से अपने आप को मूल्य रखना चाहिए. क्योंकि आप परमेश्वर, आप किसके हो? आप राजाओं के राजा, प्रभु के हो. और उसी तरह से आपको दुनिया को भी दिखाना चाहिए. आपका पिता कोई गवार गाँव में रहने वाला नहीं है, आपका पिता परमेश्वर है. उस तरह से आपको दिखना है, आपको बदलना है और उस तरह से दुनिया को भी दिखाना है, ताकि लोग आपको ये आकर कहें कि आपको भले ही कोई कौशल्य नहीं है, कौशल्य हम आपको सिखाएंगे, लेकिन आप में जो है कि आप चीजों को संभाल के रख सकते हो, आप अच्छी तरह से रख सकते हो, ये हमें आप में दिखता है. तो कृपया करके आप हमारे साथ जुड़ जाइए और हमारी कंपनी के भाग बन जाइए.
Like, let me tell you, I mean, right now, the one who is my business associate, you know, I just have a blueprint in my mind and she brings it on to me on the table. Like it's in real in front of me. It's all there. Before I can even ask her that, you know what, listen, this. She the next day, you know, which actually would require somebody a week or 2 weeks, it's on my table the next day.
Hallelujah.
So do you know the world is looking for such kind of people?
Yes.
For such kind of people. Wouldn't you want to do business with such kind of people?
Yes, absolutely.
You know, for such people, there is no limitation. It doesn't matter whether they know the field or they don't know the field, but it's the way they manage things. It's the way that they promptly are there. You know why? Because they show you that, listen to me, how much you value, I value the same.
Amen.
Even if it's not my first-hand business, even if I am an associate with you in the business, but I value your business the same.
Amen.
So do you know, till the end, you will not want to leave that person.
Yes.
And God is the one who will bring kings to such people, because kings are seeking such people. Not that, you know what, you promise somebody, you know, you say that, okay, fine, you know what, I'm gonna give it to you. I'll prepare this, make it and give it to you tomorrow. And then 10 days you're calling them. Is it done? Is my work done? 10 days later, they come and they say that, you know what, we still couldn't make it, we need 1 month more. That's not called effectivity. That's not called value. You know, you got to be a person of such value that you know that, you know what, if I have given this person a job to do, I know 110% it's going to be done.
Yes.
That's your value. And I'm telling you, if you carry such value in your business, in your job, wherever you are unique. You are very unique.
और जब आपको कोई काम दिया गया होता है, जब आप उसे तुरंत करते हो, ना कि उसे एक महीना लगाते हो कि आपको फोन करना पड़े कि हुआ क्या, ऐसे लोगों के साथ लोग काम नहीं करना चाहते। और रेवन के साथ कोई जुड़ा हुआ है उनके व्यवसाय में, जो वो बोलने से पहले ही चीजें उनके पास हासिल हो जाती है, तो ऐसे लोगों के साथ लोगों को काम करना अच्छा लगता है। कि जब आप भले ही वो कौशल आपके पास नहीं है, लेकिन उनकी चीज, उनके व्यवसाय को आप अपना व्यवसाय समझ के उस तरह से तत्परता से काम करते हो, उस तरह से उत्साह दिखाते हो, ऐसे लोगों के साथ कौन काम करना नहीं चाहेगा।
Where is your multiple sources? Have you planned your resources?
Yes.
Where are, if you have not, please go watch that sermon. Where we're talking about, it's very, very important for you to have multiple resources of income. That's the way you will become, you know, you will begin to live the life of your dream. That's the way this vision of yours of being a Moses will come to fulfillment. So even if you've not acted it out, put it in your vision book and slowly, steadily start preparing for it. Doesn't matter what's your age, how old you are, and no, because when did Abraham get his child?
99.
When he was at the peak of his age. So for God, age doesn't matter. For the kingdom doesn't work on age. No, it doesn't, right? So what happens is that wherever you are right now, begin to multiply your resources. I'm just a housewife, but I don't know what to do. I've been like this for so many years. No. Open up Proverbs 31 and read Proverbs 31.
Yes.
That's the way a woman has to be. Even nobody's asking you to earn millions. Okay, even if you start earning 100 rupees. But I'll tell you, very soon, because of your faithfulness, that 100 rupees will become a crore.
Amen.
For God, it's not possible. God says, just give me a vessel and the multiplication, I will do it. You just obey my word and I will see that you are called blessed.
Amen.
Her family calls her blessed.
Amen.
Everybody around her calls her blessed. People will call you blessed. Why? Because you have learned to be a blessing to the nations. Don't just sit and wait for charity to come from here, charity to come from there. No, that's not sensible. Get up, rise, take your vision book, write it in your vision book that by the end of this year, my next business should have already started. I don't need 10 millions to put in that business. No. Just do it in the smallest fashion, in the smallest way, and you will see, I'm telling you, it's only going to multiply.
Amen.
Beloveds, that's the only key to multiplication, or else there is no way that you can multiply. There is no way you can multiply. So I just want to leave you with this word, that let's change our mind and understand the protocols, the principles of the kingdom.
और पैसा आने के अलग अलग ग्राह होने चाहिए, अलग अलग आपके व्यवसाय होने चाहिए जिससे आपको पैसा आता है, या तो फिर आप पैसा कमा रहे हो, क्योंकि इसी तरह से आप बढ़ोगे, इसी तरह से आपकी जिंदगी में गुणन होगा, बाकी किसी तरह से नहीं होगा। तो आप कहोगे कि मैं तो हमेशा घर में ही रहती हूँ और मैं सब घर संभालती हूँ, मैं गृहिणी हूँ, लेकिन भले ही 100 रुपए से शुरुआत कीजिए, लेकिन उसमें विश्वास रहिए, भले ही करोड़ नहीं आएंगे आपके बैंक में अभी, लेकिन धीरे धीरे करके पैसा आने लगेगा, लेकिन किसी छोटी चीज से ही सही शुरुआत कीजिए और उसमें विश्वास रहिए। और आपका जो दृष्टांत की पुस्तक है उसमें लिख के रहिए कि अगले साल तक मेरा एक नया व्यवसाय शुरू हो ही जाना चाहिए, क्योंकि इसी तरह से आप गुणन कर सकते हो और उससे तरक्की पा सकते हो।
Your salvation doesn't depend on your husband's salvation. You have a personal relationship with Christ.
Yes.
So Lord, do you know I need my own money so I can give my tithes, because that's my reasonable sacrifice. That's my personal thing that I can do for you. I don't want to depend, you know, for the other things. It's very strange, you know. Girls and women and in this age need space from their husbands. Space. I need space. I'm going with my friends. I'm going here, going there. Seriously, what if one day the husband gets up and says, you know what? You need space financially. Let's place our financials. Talk about space. No, that's being fair. Yeah, I know there's a lot of women empowerment, but the poor men. God, we even considered them. It was not Adam always was wrong. What when the man or the woman, whoever it could be, says that now let's just have financial space. Beloveds, your relationship with Christ is personal. If you love Him so much, don't do it for yourself, but just do it because I'm going to give you my hard work. I'm going to give it to you, right? And you see those things which you've never dreamt of will just begin to happen, and you'll be like, my God, from what to what have I become?
और दुनिया ये कहती है कि आजकल औरतें ये कहती हैं कि मुझे समय चाहिए और मुझे जगह चाहिए, अपनी जगह चाहिए, अपने पति से कहती हैं कि मैं अपने दोस्तों के साथ घूम सकूं और मुझे अपना समय चाहिए, लेकिन कभी किसी दिन पति उठकर कहेगा कि तुम्हें अभी अपने पैसे भी चाहिए, मैं तुम्हें पैसे नहीं दूंगा, तब क्या होगा। तो हमें इसी तरह से हमें खुद का होना चाहिए ताकि हम परमेश्वर को खुद का दे सके। जो हमारा तारण है वो हमारा निजी रिश्ता है परमेश्वर के साथ। आपका तारण आपके पति के तारण से भर नहीं होता, तो उसी तरह से आपका निजी दशमांश, आपका खुद की हुई मेहनत परमेश्वर को दिखाइए।
So wonderful people of God, I just want to close here. Listen to me, Elijah quickly realized that the brook was getting dry. Why? Because the water was dry, no more food. It's a sign that I got to move to the next place where my provision is available.
Amen.
Not just talking in business or in job or whatever. I'm talking about even in your nature, even in the place, your spiritual. Prosperity means spiritual, financial.
Yes.
Finance is just one part of it.
Yes.
It means in your relationships. It means in a lot of other things, your whole life, every area should be prosperous.
Yes.
So when I realize that, oh my God, I'm not bearing fruits, I'm just stagnant. My prayers have become the same. Everything is same. You know, I need to move to the next place of provision.
और एलिया का ये बहुत अच्छा था कि उसने समय होते ही पहचान लिया कि अब ये झरना सूख रहा है और मुझे यहाँ से निकलना है। आपके व्यवसाय के बारे में ही नहीं, आपके रिश्ते हो सकते हैं या कोई भी चीज, आपकी आत्मिक परिस्थिति हो सकती है जिसमें आपको पता चल रहा है कि मेरी प्रार्थनाएं सूखी हो रही है और वैसे ही मैं दोहरा रहा हूँ, तो तब आपको ये जानना है कि मुझे अभी यहाँ से निकलना है, कि मुझे इसमें फल नहीं दिखाई दे रहे, मुझे इसे बदलना है।
All right. So, beloveds, this is just my prayer for you that you receive the grace to do it the kingdom way. That's all
Amen.
That I want to pray for you. That Father, you will give them the grace to do it the kingdom way.
Amen.
और परमेश्वर से आज सिर्फ यही प्रार्थना करेंगे आपके लिए कि परमेश्वर उन्हें अनुग्रह दे ताकि वो तेरे राज्य के सिद्धांत की तरह, तेरे राज्य के नियम की तरह चीजें कर सके।
In Jesus name,
यीशु मसीह के नाम से।
Amen. Amen.
Praise God. And beloveds, I want to thank each and every one of you all who are watching us on YouTube and Facebook. And I request everyone to like, share and subscribe and ring the bell And do share this video with your family members, your friends, and everyone who want to be blessed. Stay blessed and enjoy the videos.